It's hype. Look at that ogre magi stash, bro. Oh, baby. I'll smork all the time. Let's go. Everyone else is spending gold? Oh, man. I don't know. I don't think this deck needs any other cards. I'ma just wait for the second 12 hours and just build, like, something good. We're gonna play something weird, dude. I'm just gonna play all legendary deck, be like, sup? No, that'd be bad. I'd probably lose. Alright, coin 2 into 2, into 3, into 4. This hand is one curvy hand. Alright, coin 2. We're gonna use the one we kept, because he knows we kept this card, so he knows it's an early game play or something related to my curve. So I want to use it since he already has information about it, and I don't want to, like, reveal the fact that I have another early game 2 drop. The top deck scientist. The mind games, bros. Alright, let's just develop this guy and trade minions before weapons. Except when weapons protect minions. I think we got, like, 4 more hours till class swap or something. Something like that. I don't know. There was, like, delays and stuff, so I don't know how that's gonna work with the class swap and stuff. But it's not too far away. Well, the trade here actually protects. So let's do the trade. Ferocious. Greasy Trap, not gonna be picking up too much value here, but you never know. Faced with Shredder. Yeah, I've been getting sniped by too many priests, so I just threw Shredders in there to fuck with them. I think I'm done bleeding now, so that's good. I was losing a lot of blood. Oh man, he's got concentrate. 2-3, 2-3, 2-3, 1-4. There you go. Dude, this guy's sick with Glaivzooka. I can turn him into a 3-4. Card's insane. I hope this messed up his turn. He's trying to play like Azadrake or something and can't do it. I like the presence of this dude. Even though, like, it's expensive and I miss a hero power, so it's the same thing as using a hero power. We need to get cards out of our hand for these anyways, so it's, like, fine. And it could possibly could connect for 4 instead of just for 2, since it's a naked board, man. Oh, man. Let's just blow through this. So many weapons. Oh no, another second consecrate. Acolyte of Pain's weird. This guy's gonna have heals in his deck. I can feel it. Let's get the maximum possible damage in. Set up for lethal. Try and kill him. No way he runs heals. If he does run heals, the Arcane Golem doesn't really help him, because he's probably going to land hands anyway. Whiff. No Guardian of Kings. Alright. No Holy Light. Or that two cost thing that gives you plus 4 health and 2 attack. Don't do those cards. If you Voodoo Doctor me, then that's fair. You deserve to win. Cool, we made it. Baby. Winstreaking at 9. Oh, baby, baby. All right. Alright, 1 and 2. Snakeys can be pretty good against Zoo, but we've been seeing a lot of Handlock with double heal by Jurexis in their top 10, so it's probably going to be that. Seems to be a really standard meta choice to have both Healbots and Jurexis all in their top 10. And every fucking taunter. But it's okay, we got 2 quick shots in here now, so we should be able to farm Handlocks over the top. They put delays so no sniping. I'm pretty sure there are like short delays, but people do tricks to bypass the delays. Like, for example, like everyone that's added me to my friends list, probably. There's a lot of people that added me to the friends list. I verse those people, and they just like wait for the friends list image to pop up here. So they time it, and then they figure out what the delay is, and then they queue into you. People do this. People are crazy, man. They go the distance. This hand, to me, says hit him in the face. That's a good one. No, not that one. That's a bad one. All right, that's a pretty good one. Oh man, really? You're gonna fully kill my Haunted Creeper. And you're not gonna use Zimka? Oh, there you go. Who fully kills the Haunted Creeper? I have a lot of damage. Alright, 3, 6, 9, 10, 11. I like quick shot, unleash something. Pretty sure I could just like hero power, kill command face this turn. Unleash quick shot next turn, then hero power. This is probably a proper way to play this hand though. It's probably like this, and then like that. that. Seems good to me. Oh no. I thought my presence was gonna be hard to deal with. And we need two turns to kill him, so he's trying to like stall for time with some doges. Alright. 3, 6, 7, 8. There's no way he kills me next turn. Oh, did we kill him? 4, 7, 8, 9. Not quite. We don't want to play this because then he can get Mal'Ganis off that, right? So I want to hit him for 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I just want to do... set him down to 2 to play around Lotheb. And then just hero power him next turn. Call it a day. Now he's about to sack pack. Pull out Mal'Ganis. And then we're going to call it... good game. Well played, Pele. Did we just die? Alright. Missed one hound. If we kill command first though, it doesn't die, so then we actually have to lose that hound, and then we just give him more imps, and then it's awkward. So we could create another hound, but we gotta run into the taunt, which is just not the purpose of the taunt. I mean, that's the purpose of the taunt, not the purpose of the hound. So it wouldn't have been good. So I like the way we did it, because we didn't really want... we didn't really want the opponent to have more damage, because it's a race.